Hey, Greg, Floyd Schofield, or a.k.a. Kid Austin.
Yeah.
Him and his pop really been going at Keyshawn.
Yeah, I've been hearing about it, but I ain't get to see it yet.
Like, do you think that's a realistic fight right now?
I think the fight can happen, right? And I think it should happen. When fighters start talking like that, either side, because Keyshawn been running his mouth. We know what he could do. We know what Kid Austin could do. They both been in there, 10 rounders. Match them up. We already got, like I said, we got the ball rolling with these great fights. Keep making the great fights. This is how you're going to find out if you really got a dog or if you wasted your money. You know what I mean? Because someday you might have to find out anyway. So I think they should go ahead and get it right now.
Yeah, but in boxing terms, do you want to find out with one of your dogs or do you want to find out with a cross-promotional dog?
I would want to find out either way because I want to know what I'm holding on to. I want to know if I got me a Kerr or if I got me a grand champion. I mean, of course, I want a grand champion, so I want to see. Let's go.
Who do you favor in that fight?
Keyshawn, for sure. Keyshawn got a world of experience. He meaner. He's sharper. Energetic. I mean, good reflexes. Strong kid. Kid Austin's strong as well, but Kid Austin's all over the place. He don't have no formula. You know what I mean? The reason he don't have no formula is because I don't really think they believe in working on it. I think they just more so get in shape and just, you know, have him spar whoever to build his confidence and then so on and so forth. You know what I mean? He is a strong kid, but his skill set is not there with a Keyshawn Davis.
How does that fight end? Decision or stoppage?
Keyshawn stopped him like in the seventh, eighth round.
Any competitive fight or just systematic?
It'll be competitive for about 3 rounds, and then you'll see the separation after 3 rounds. Keyshawn will pull off on him. He'll whoop on him a little bit. If Schofield got some fight in him, then he'll fight back probably rounds 4, 5, and 6. And then 7, he'll begin to break. I mean,
no. Is that moving back for Keyshawn?
No, it's not moving back. It's an undefeated kid that people know. You know what I mean? And like I said, he got some 10 rounders under his belt. So it's not like he's new to the rounds or new to the spotlight. You know what I mean? He's been the main event before. He's been the co-main event. He's been on TV a bunch of times. So, you know what I mean? I think it's a great fight.
What do you want to see from Floyd Schofield ahead of that Keyshawn fight that will kind of even the odds, in your opinion?
I think if he really studied under Ronnie Shields, it'll be a better fight. His dad don't know too much about boxing. I think he believes he know a lot about the body, but he don't know too much about boxing. And I think he should let Ronnie Shields go ahead and take care of that for him, and then I think they'll be a little bit more successful.